from the NBC studios in Burbank, California, The Tonight Show with Jay Leno, featuring Bradford Marsalis and The Tonight Show Band. Tonight, Jay welcomes Natalie Cole, comedian Drew Carey, and from Last Action Hero, Austin O'Brien, I'm Matt Hall, and now, Jay Leno.
To the Tonight Show. Good to see everybody. Thank you very much. Friday night. You all getting ready for Father's Day?
Yeah.
As you know, Father's Day this Sunday. Got my dad's perfect gift this year, the Jurassic Park tie. You seen these? Nice thing is, it's guaranteed to sit in a drawer for 65 million years. It's a nice thing. You know who I feel sorry for on Father's Day? The Statler brothers. You ever seen these guys? There's no way they can have the same father, okay? There's just no way. Well, let's see what's going on in Washington. At last night's press conference, President Clinton said his first 6 months in office have been a success. Oh, yeah. And Pepsi had a great week, too, huh? Did anybody see last night's press conference? You know, Bill Clinton compared himself to Thomas Jefferson. Now, I like Bill Clinton, I really do, but this is a little premature, isn't it? I mean, look, Thomas Jefferson, what, wrote the Declaration of Independence, engineered the Louisiana Purchase, founded the University of Virginia. I mean, the only thing Clinton's done so far is got Fleetwood Mac back together. You know, geez, not quite the same. I'll tell you something. Do you know that NBC was the only network to show President Clinton last night? The other networks didn't show the press conference. Instead of airing President... Yay. Instead of airing President Clinton's news conference, ABC showed Matlock. CBS showed The Magic of David Copperfield. Huh? Between the lawyer, the magician, and Clinton, I don't know who to believe. You know? It's a very tough show to, yeah. You know, it's interesting, though, if you did watch a press conference, Clinton used terminology identical to what Ronald Reagan used to use. Because David Gergen, you know, the guy who used to work for Reagan, now works for Clinton. Pretty embarrassing, too. At the end, you see that part where Clinton thanked his wife Nancy and his good friend Ed Meese? Oh, man. See what else is going on with President. President Clinton says he's now planning to take his mother-in-law and his daughter with him when they go visit the Far East. Boy, times have changed, huh? 23 years ago, you couldn't even get one Clinton to go to the Far East. Now, boy, they're all going. It's unbelievable. They're all going now. Actually, Clinton had some good stuff this week. The Supreme Court nominee seems like a pretty bright, intelligent woman. This is Ruth Bader Ginsburg. She says in preparation for her upcoming confirmation hearing, she is studying old tapes of Foghorn Leghorn cartoons. You know Foghorn Leghorn? You know the cartoon? Well, she's doing this so she can understand questions from Strom Thurmond and Howell Heflin. You know, just to kind of help her through that difficult period. Yeah. Let's see what else is going on. President Clinton's 1967 Mustang convertible is now on display at an auto museum in Arkansas. The car has hardly any miles on it at all. Well, that makes sense. You ever see the way Clinton drives? I mean, he goes 3 miles forward, then he backs up for 2 miles. Then he goes 6 miles ahead, then he backs up again for 4 miles. So see, kind of get the mileage. Yeah, it tends to take care of itself. Yeah. Actually, there was some bad news about Clinton's car in the paper today. Did you see this? Apparently, Bob Dole showed up at the museum and crushed Clinton's car with a monster truck. Yeah. Yeah. It wasn't one of my favorites either. We argued over that one. Well, I guess the authorities now are pretty convinced that Pepsi had nothing to do with the tampering that's been going on with their soda cans. You know about this thing. It turns out, well, this is what they think. They think the Diet Pepsi with the syringe in it was a hoax by copycats that weren't that bright. They had another one today. Did you hear about this? A guy claimed he bought a popsicle and there was a stick in it. Yeah. That's the big thing, these stupid copycat crimes. This is true. This week alone, it's got nothing to do with Pepsi, but people have reported finding nails, screws, and bolts in cans of Diet Pepsi. Nails, screws, and bolts. You know, today I was at the store, and I said to the clerk, excuse me, where's the Diet Pepsi? He goes, are you on hardware, Department 5, I'll say. Terrible. And it's not just Diet Pepsi. The tampering is not just limited to Diet Pepsis. Today, somebody claimed their Cracker Jacks have been tampered with. You see this? I guess they opened it and they found a prize inside that was actually worth something. So they right away, they suspected. No. Other political news. Oh, how about this? We had some folks from Rhode Island here. Did I hear that before? Yeah, yeah. How about your governor? You know about this? And yesterday, Rhode Island Governor Bruce Sundland admitted paternity of a 17-year-old girl. He admitted, finally, he was a father. Isn't that typical of a politician? He timed it just in time to get a Father's Day gift. Boy, these guys, now they're unbelievable. He could have waited till next week, but no, he wants that tie. He wants the bottle of Old Spice. You know whose birthday it is today? Film critic Roger Ebert. It's his birthday today. You know Roger Ebert of Siskel and Ebert fame? They held a party for him. Actually, you know, it was kind of embarrassing. Do you know his own family doesn't even know if he's the short, chubby one or the tall, balding guy? You know? Isn't that sad? Your own family. You know whose birthday is tomorrow? Salman Rushdie. You know the guy that wrote Satanic Verses, the guy the Iranians are after there? Well, let's hope his friends don't plan a surprise party for this guy, huh? I mean, the last thing he needs is a bunch of people jumping out of the dark on surprise! Now, here's a true story. This sounds like an old joke. This is in the paper today. In California, how can I put this delicately here? A man whose impotence was cured by a special electronic implant now claims it accidentally starts to operate every time neighbors use their automatic garage door. I'm not making this up. I'm not making this up. That's what the guy says. This is what the guy says. He says, every time they use the automatic garage door, this thing starts to operate. And you know something? At 5:30 every night, his wife is the happiest woman in the neighborhood. You know, just, no, this is a true story. It sounds like that old garage door pacemaker joke. True story. And a recent survey in Glamour magazine says 86% of the women in this country, 86%, would like to see more male nudity on screen during films. Yeah? You guys like to see more male nudity? Really? Really? I mean, is there any need to see Jack Palance in a movie crossing and uncrossing his legs like Sharon Stone? I mean, do you want to see that? Here's something we've been talking about all week, where we're in the disgusting joke part of the show. Scientists have invented a portable urinal men can use while driving. Can you imagine it? Huh? Yes, you like that idea? Huh? If this doesn't bring back the return of plastic seat covers, I don't know what will, okay? Isn't that gross? Isn't that disgusting? Driving around with a urinal in your car? Huh? You thought it was obnoxious when the windshield washer flew to the car in front of you got sprayed on you. Oh, man, it's terrible. Terrible. It is terrible. It's a terrible thing, certainly. And if it was not in the news, we wouldn't even have mentioned it. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we got a terrific show tonight. A fine, fine performer. Where do you see what she's got planned? There's like hundreds of musicians behind that curtain at this very moment. Natalie Cole is here. Natalie Cole is here. A very funny comedian, a man who did a show get picked up here on NBC. Did I hear that today? Drew's show? Oh, good, good. Very funny comedian. Just got a show virtually moments ago, ladies and gentlemen. Drew Carey is here. Drew Carey. And the young star, along with Arnold Schwarzenegger of Last Action Hero, 12-year-old Austin O'Brien. Very talented young man. He'll be out with us. And of course, well, we're on the subject of talented young men, ladies and gentlemen. The president of the Men Without Ties Club, Mr. Branford Marsalis, is here on the Tonight Show band. Yes!
1, 2, 3.
As you all may know, Sunday is Father's Day, the day when we honor dads everywhere. But these are the 90s, a time when some families are, well, as they say in the daytime talk shows, a little dysfunctional. Yeah. Now, that's not to say a dysfunctional dad is a bad dad. He just does things a little differently, as we'll see right now as we explore the differences between a regular dad and a dysfunctional dad. Regular dad, the barbecue apron reads, "Kiss me, I'm the cook." Dysfunctional dad, barbecue apron reads, "You want something to cry about? Hey, I'll give you something to cry about." Regular dad forgives you for getting into an accident. Oh, I know my dad did. Yeah. Dysfunctional dad constantly refers to you as his little accident. Yeah. Regular dad teaches you to drive, a real bonding experience. Dysfunctional dad teaches you to yell whiplash and fake a back injury. Yeah. Regular dad takes you trick-or-treating on Halloween. Boy, that was always a lot of fun, yeah? Dysfunctional dad takes you with him on a masked liquor store robbery. Regular dad enjoys watching you play ball. That was always a thrill, having your dad watching you play ball. Dysfunctional dad enjoys dressing up like Lucille Ball. Regular dad tells you about the facts of life, a very important part of boyhood, yeah, yeah. Dysfunctional dad currently serving 10 years to life. Yeah. Regular dad, his hobby, trying to get a ship in a bottle. Always a lot of fun. Dysfunctional dad, hobby, putting syringes in cans of Diet Pepsi. Regular dad, teaches you how to ice skate. Yeah. Dysfunctional dad, puts on a hockey mask and shows up at summer camp. All right. See, it's all how you sell the gag, really. Regular dad, collects stamps. Good dad hobby. Dysfunctional dad collects photos of Sharon Stone, keeps them in a secret shrine in the crawl space. Regular dad can't program the VCR. Dysfunctional dad can't program the VCR. And finally, regular dad takes you out to the ball game, buys you peanuts and Cracker Jacks. Dysfunctional dad doesn't care if you ever come back. All right, ladies and gentlemen. But we'll be right back right after. I'll see you later. Bye.
Hi.
Hi.
What are you doing here?
I live here, remember?
Yeah, but I thought you were working late.
Gave myself the night off.
Yeah. We'll go out. I'll change.
Let's stay home. I'll change.
Only Blockbuster has so many movies, so many ways to make your night off a Blockbuster night.
Did I hear the phone?
Phone?
So pick up a movie from Blockbuster and make it a Blockbuster night.
Do all luxury cars deaden your sense of hearing? Your sense of touching? Feeling the road? When your luxury car is one of the new BMW 5 Series V8s. Their sense of the road reduces the competition to senseless luxury.
No lawyer has ever left your law firm alive.
They can get to anyone, anywhere.
I know you'll do your best to protect the firm, won't you, Mitch?
Get out of here. They know. Get out.
The Firm, rated R. Starts Wednesday, June 30th, everywhere.
Fragrance from Guy La Roche Paris. Feel the power.
Now, the Power Gear Sport Duffel is your gift with any $29.50 Drakkar Noir purchase. Available at wine stocks.
Oakwood Lake Resort introduces something fun to scream about. The Jet Scream Water Slide, new for 93 at Oakwood Lake Resort. This summer's a scream.
Ah, The Tonight Show would like to congratulate two of our affiliates in Hawaii, KHAW in Hilo and KHON in Honolulu, on their 40th anniversaries with NBC. So thanks, you guys. All righty. My first guest, a very talented former whose last album sold 8 million copies, you guys, and won 7 Grammys. Pretty amazing. She'll be performing at the Hollywood Bowl July 16th through the 18th. Her brand new CD, Take a Look, was just released this week. Please welcome Natalie Cole. You know, you like the girl who used to sit in front of me in school and said, I'm going to flunk the test. This afternoon, she's going, oh, my throat. You know, I don't know
but
if I can
is.
Sing. Oh, I'll try to fake
no,
my
no,
way
no.
through.
I'm
it sounded
about
great.
60%.
It sounded great.
No, really, but thanks.
Oh, come 60%?
Yeah.
Well, if it was 100, you would have blown the place out. I'll stop you like, oh, I'm going to flunk the test. Ooh, I got an A. I see what that. You know, I'm sitting there going, oh, is that like a bra? And is her shirt open? Oh, I see. It's a whole thing. Okay, I'm sitting there going, oh, yeah, no, that's great. No, don't change anything. But see, from my point of view, I'm going, oh, well, this is like cable now. But I realize, I see, it's a whole thing you're wearing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes,
so what do you do for your throat? Do you take special?
I've been back here doing everything. We got cayenne pepper. We got honey. We got vinegar. We got ginseng.
Vinegar?
Halls, Vicks, everything.
Now, why vinegar? Why?
Well, vinegar cuts the phlegm, you know, the stuff that makes you go.
That sounds very romantic, yeah. Well, somebody told me.
But it works. It does.
Who was it, Mathis, or somebody told me raw onion?
Oh, yeah, raw onion, I think, seeped in honey. And then you let it sit there for a minute, and then you take it out and you eat
the, And the nice thing about that is you don't have to worry about the host of the show kissing you when you come out.
This is true.
You don't have that
this
embarrassing moment.
Yeah.
So you're going back to UMass?
Yes, yep. I was back there. It was terrific.
Oh, you were back. You know, okay, you just, you're
no,
just
no,
there.
No,
okay.
I went already.
Oh, all right.
And I got my doctorate in fine arts. Easiest doctorate I ever got.
Wow.
Yeah.
What was your major?
Dr. Cole to you.
Oh, it's Dr. Cole.
That's
Dr.
Right.
Cole, excuse me. That's what I remember when you, when we used to work together
I
there
know.
In that
you
place.
You should see what I put in your book.
Oh, I'll check it out and
yeah,
see.
Yeah.
We used to play the blue
see,
wall.
See, for those of you who don't know, okay, Jay and I was a student at UMass, and Jay was doing comedy then at a place called the Blue Wall Cafe, and I was upstairs in a restaurant called Top of the Campus, and we were, you know, breaking ourselves in, and I would come down and check him out, and
well,
did
they
you
had
ever
fancy.
Come up and check me out?
I did check you out. I checked you out, okay. And just as I checked you out a few moments ago. Yeah. Believe me. I was always, always checking you out. It's not a problem. So, now, what was your degree in when you were there?
Psychology.
Psychology.
Yeah.
Okay, so you know, like, if it's half empty or half full, you would know.
Half full.
Okay,
yes.
That's very good.
That's the positive.
Right. So, very
accentuate
good.
Accentuate the positive, huh?
Oh, that's very good.
Oh, yes.
That's very good. So now you're a doctor.
Yes, of fine arts.
Okay.
Yes.
Oh, that's very exciting.
It was really, really a wonderful day. Yeah. They graduated like 4,000 students, and everyone was in their cap and gowns, and I had my little cap and gown thing, and it was...
Oh,
I was really excited.
Yeah.
I hadn't been back there in like 20 years. And my English teacher from freshman year actually came up to me at the reception afterwards. I had to ask him what was I like as a student, because I don't even remember.
All kind of a haze.
Yeah, it was all kind of a blur. But he said I was pretty cool. I always sat in the back, but I think I was an okay student.
You were a 15-year-old. Is
mm-hmm.
he 15?
He's around here somewhere.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. What is he kind of music? Is this his kind of music?
Yeah. He likes this.
Yeah.
He likes, he keeps me, you know, hip to what's going on with the new stuff, Dr. Dre, Naughty by Nature, and Mary J. Blige. I know them all.
Now, they have to move your head when you say Mary J. Blige.
You have to move your head when you say Mary J. Blige.
You can't just say the name. You have to move into the name.
You got to move a little bit.
You got to get into the name.
Jodeci and that kind of stuff.
Okay. You going to do another song for us?
Yes.
That's we got the strings and stuff, too.
Yeah. Now, this next song we're going to do is a song that my dad wrote.
Oh, good.
And you have to be serious, serious fans to remember this song.
Okay.
Serious heart.
Oh, I'm sure they are. We'll take a little break. Be right back, right after this. More with Natalie.
Come in.
Kevin Dave, we're here. Say, nice place you got here.
Ooh. Dave, you remember the twins, Norma Jean, her boyfriend Luke, and this is Zing Chow, our exchange student.
What's happening?
I'm starved.
Well, we go to Wendy's.
This summer, Wendy's has something for everyone, like junior bacon cheeseburgers and Caesar side salads on the 99-cent super value menu, and a hamburger kids meal for $1.99.
Yeah, time to go.
So soon?
You talked us into it. We're staying.
When it comes to the safety of your loved ones, Toyota cares.
Everything's gonna be all right.
So the Previa was equipped with side door impact beams and a roof that meets car strength standards.
It's gonna be okay.
Which makes Previa the only van to meet all federal car safety standards with a driver's side airbag.
Don't worry, sweetie.
After all, Toyota knows how protective you are of your babies.
We're here, honey.
Even the big one.
Why put up with glasses that are too heavy? LensCrafters exclusive featherweight lenses are lighter, slimmer, and oh so comfortable.
I never knew glasses could be this comfortable.
LensCrafters exclusive featherweight lenses. Lighter weight for greater comfort in about an hour.
You are here. He has the traveler's checks here. What can you do? Well, do this. Carry American Express traveler's checks for two. The only checks either of you can use. Don't leave home without them.
Anytime, any place,
go fish,
anyone, any taste,
go fish,
any day, any night, any size, appetite, one place doesn't rhyme,
go fish!
At Long John's, get what you want, any way you want it, from combo platters to baked meals, from value packs to $1.99 specials.
You can get your wish,
anytime,
go fish, Long John Silver's.
Go for one of our three great $1.99 specials, and don't forget to add a piece.
My next guest, a very funny comedian. He can be seen at the Ohio Theater in Cleveland on June 26th. where he'll be taping his Showtime special. Please welcome Drew Carey.
Okay. Thanks. I don't know what to tell you, except don't ever go to Supercuts. And if you do, don't give them any guff. Because, man, they take it out on you. So, I guess for Father's Day, you just want to have somebody on that looks like your dad. Thanks. Great to be here in healthy Southern California. Everybody's so concerned about their health. Where's your smokers in the crowd? You people that smoke? Yeah. Killing yourselves, you know that, don't you? That's right, slow suicide with the cigarettes. And of course you know that, because people in L.A. tell you every time you light up. Man, you can't get enough good advice when you're smoking a cigarette, can you? Every time you light a match, you're killing yourself. Holy cow, I didn't know that. Jeez, you gotta be kidding me. Oh, I'm glad you showed up. God bless you, citizen. Hey, honey, I almost killed myself. This guy saved my life. Whew, death in a box, man. That's how people expect you to act, isn't it, when they butt into your life? Like, you're supposed to be so grateful they pointed out your faults to you, you know, try to help you out. Like, say, you know that cheeseburger is going to give you a heart attack. What? I almost swallowed that thing. Gee. Doesn't the government regulate this stuff? Thank God for you, sir. I almost had a moment of joy. Safety Nazi, buzz off. People are too worried about their health and dying. People think about that dying and death stuff too much. Everybody's made out a living will in my whole family, except for me. I'm the only one that's not gonna make out a living will because I think they're a bad idea, and here's why. See, if you have a living will, you can tell your family, your friends, your doctor, that if you ever slip into a coma or turn into a vegetable for some reason, you give them permission to go ahead and unplug you and put you out of your misery. What kind of nonsense is that? Here, let me ask you something. What if being a vegetable is the greatest thing that ever happened to you? You know, you don't know. How are you going to tell me you changed your mind? You can't. You're stuck. You signed a paper. You'll be laying in a coma. Boy, I never felt better in my life. Oh, I love this coma. Whoa, who'd have thunk? Here comes the doctor and the nurse to unplug you. Hey, cut it out. I'm going to enjoy my coma. Hell, I'm not paying for it. I got family, I got Medicare. Hey, don't touch me. It'd be like having a government job. Yeah, it'd be like working for the post office or something. You're not no postal workers out there, is there? Put the gun down, just joking. You don't want to mess with the post office. They're on a hair trigger down there. What's gotten into postal workers lately, man? Did something get into the glue? It was like every 10th stamp. Huh. These guys are, doesn't it seem like once a year a postal worker has to flip out and shoot up the joint? Then they blame it on the stress. I gotta be kidding. Oh, the sleet, the snow. Ooh. It's the dogs, man. They're everywhere. The dogs. I can't get the dogs. So stressful about working at the post office. They don't do anything. I've been to the post office. Probably under a lot of stress lately because they can't do the math anymore since they went to 29-cent stamps. Pardon me, I'd like 6 29-cent stamps. Speaking of death and destruction, I moved to Los Angeles here just a couple years ago. I live in Hollywood, and I don't know if you guys have ever been to Hollywood proper, but it is a hellhole, boy, I'm telling you. It's not glamorous at all. There's nothing but hookers and winos every 5 feet. You can't even walk down the street. No, get away from me. No, don't want any. No, don't touch me. No, look. It'd be one thing if they were just homeless people and you could help them out. You feel bad for them, but they're just drunk winos. There's a big difference between a poor homeless guy and a drunk wino going, hey, give me a dollar. That's all I do. Give me a dollar. I'm not going to give you a dollar. Earn the dollar. Jump up and down. Play the kazoo. You know. Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my right hand. Da-da-da-da. Yeah. One good thing about living in Hollywood, the only good thing, you see a lot of celebrities, I'm still kind of starstruck, you know. I saw Sally Struthers walking down the street. That was kind of cool. Yeah, gave her a dollar, and I just fucked up. She's got the ad for the correspondence school. That's when I started to feel bad for her doing that ad. I think correspondence schools are like full of it, man. How can correspondence schools teach you all that stuff through the mail? I saw an ad. They claim they teach you veterinary medicine through the mail. Jeez, I hate to be a dog in that house. Mail's here. Man. You know, I never thought I'd see an actress stoop so low for money until I saw Suzanne Summers for the Thigh Mask. That, they didn't mean to make it, but that's the funniest commercial on TV, I'm telling you. I never left, so you have to look for the funny part. There's a woman that comes on in the middle of the commercial. She zips up her jeans, and then she says, "Thank you, Thigh Master." Thank you very much.
You know, I'm glad it's Friday, because I won't have to answer any of this mail till Monday. Please address your cards on the Drew Carey care of the Tonight Show. Very funny stuff.
I'll answer. Thanks. I appreciate it. I love the show.
Huh?
I love the show. You know, your director, Ellen, is going to be directing my Showtime special.
Oh, is that right?
Yep, she'll be flying to Cleveland.
She's moonlighting?
That's right.
Wow.
Obviously, you're not paying her enough dough.
Oh, really? I guess you'll have to carry it from now on. No, she told me she's doing that. She's very excited about it, so that should be fun.
She got a note from you, I know.
Huh?
I know she got a note from you. She can do it.
Yeah, she did. Yes, she did. I got a little note. Please excuse Ellen.
Yeah.
Now, you just drove, what, across the whole country now?
Yeah, I didn't know I was going to be doing the Tonight Show, so I planned to have it in my car out in Cleveland, so I thought I'd drive out there. I'd drive out there in 3 days. I saw all of America, and have a little tip, if I may, a little tip for everybody in America. If you don't have a good body, cover it up. Too many rest stops, seeing too many people. Like, ugh.
Yeah, it's.
You know, I saw this is all everywhere. I was in Atlantic City. Did you ever go there? I was in Atlantic City. This guy was on the boardwalk. He wasn't on the beach where it'd be legal. He was on a boardwalk where people were trying to eat. And he had his shirt off, big fat hairy belly hanging out. I know you've seen this guy. He travels all over the country. Wearing nothing but flip flops and a little pair of Speedos. Puffing a cigar. Like, where's the babes? Yeah, where's the babes? They're in the bushes throwing up.
He'll be in Cleveland June 26th, taping his own special for Showtime. Good seeing you, Drew. Very funny stuff. Drew Carey, be right back.
What exactly is it that makes a Ford Escort GT so much fun? Well, let's start with its powerful 16-valve dual overhead cam engine. It's a blast. A scream. It really cooks. Then there's Escort GT's great looks. You know, the kind that'll turn more heads than a screwdriver. Speaking of turns, that's where Escort GT's nimble sport suspension comes in. We're talking road hugging. So ask yourself, isn't it time for a little fun?
Yes!
And have you driven a Ford lately?
Introducing, for a limited time, the Taco Bell Wild Burritos. As tasty as the originals, with one little difference. They're hot, man.
There's that car again.
Yeah, the Altima.
Since its introduction, the Nissan Altima has not only become the fastest-selling new car in our history, it's become the best-selling new car nameplate in America.
Just like that, huh?
Now that you can lease an Altima for just $199 a month, who knows what will happen?
I guess that's what'll happen.
Lease an Altima XE for $1,000 down and just $199 a month for 36 months at your neighborhood Nissan dealer.
most suspenseful movie you'll see isn't in any theater. It's only on NBC. One woman's obsession.
Why can't you just love me?
Becomes one man's nightmare.
We better go talk to the police.
Damn it! I didn't kill him!
Sally Kirkland in a world premiere. Double Deception. NBC Monday.
At Lazy Boy Furniture Galleries, you'll find that some of our most popular styles are in 1 minute and out the next. Right now, every price on every recliner is so hot, it's practically sizzling. Announcing Lazy Boy Furniture Gallery's Hot Seat Sale. Hurry in before we put this offer on ice.
Get our most popular styles while they're hot at the Lazy Boy Furniture Gallery now.
How much gasoline does your car waste?
Dirty intake valves and fuel injectors can hurt your car's fuel economy. Over the average life of a car, that's precious gallons of wasted gasoline. But now there's new Formula Shell. All three grades reduce harmful engine deposits other gasolines can leave behind to help your car and your budget run at peak efficiency. Formula Shell, the cleanest reason yet to go with the world's best-selling gasoline. Shell, miles ahead.
You know what I hate about those TV award shows? The stupid acceptance speeches. I'd like to thank blah, 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 the Dalai Lama, blah, 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 Shirley MacLaine in my past lives. Instead of statues, they should give Crystal ice cream. You see, even though Crystal costs a lot less than the premium brands, it's so delicious, those Hollywood types will be too busy eating to give a speech. Well, I'd like to thank... this is delicious. It's really an honor. Who's responsible for the ice cream? I must go.
This is KCRA-TV, the home of Live Copter 3.
Coming up next week on the program, Don Johnson will be here, Gloria Estefan, Matthew Modine, boxer Tommy Morrison, Rip Torn from the Larry Sanders Show, Willie Nelson, and the greatest comedian in the world, who could be our next boss, Mr. Bill Cosby, will be here, ladies and gentlemen. So that should be exciting. You know, here's something pretty frightening. A few days ago, a woman in New York City was misdiagnosed as being dead. You hear about this story? In fact, she was alive. They gave some excuse that her readings were so low, they thought she was dead. This mistake is not as uncommon as you may think, and we have a chart here which shows other excuses that people give when they get caught, you know, misdiagnosing a living person as dead. Here, 12% of the excuses was absence the day death was covered in the class. That's an interesting one here. 15% think someone's dead when relatives are already dividing up the person's belongings. That's a good way. Person was not startled when offered a can of Diet Pepsi. 6%. Yeah, pretty much. I think that's pretty much the last Pepsi joke for a long, long time. The person showed no interest in seeing Jurassic Park. They thought he was dead for that reason. Here's an answer. 9% guy who looked like the devil screamed, "This one's mine." That'll do it, too. Here's another reason. Person's chest was moving up and down like the dead bodies on Murder, She Wrote. 15%. You ever watch those people on Murder, She Wrote? They're always like this. He's dead. And you see him breathing and one end. And anyway, here's the 25%. The largest reason. Person had the same vital signs as Keith Richards. Yeah. All right, be right back with Natalie Cole and Austin O'Brien right after this.
It is a responsive dual overhead cam engine, but it's not a Mercedes. It is a highly advanced multiple link suspension system, but it's not a BMW. And it has an airbag with terminals plated in gold, but it's not a Lexus. It's an entirely different kind of luxury sedan. It's an affordable one, the Nissan Altima. See it at your Nissan dealer today.
Be a bird. kinds of dads in this world. And this Father's Day, Sears has Dockers for all of them. All on sale at the lowest prices of the season. Dockers pants just $24.88. Dockers shirts $19.88. And Dockers shorts also $19.88. Sears has all different kinds of Dockers to fit all different kinds of dads. Because there's one thing all dads seem to have in common. Dads love Dockers. And this Father's Day, the place to get them all on sale is Sears.
Oakwood Lake Resort introduces something fun to scream about. The Jet Scream Water Slide, new for 93 at Oakwood Lake Resort. This summer's a scream.
Wine Stock's summer sale and values. For every pair of shoes you buy from our Blue Dot collection, you get a second pair of equal or lesser value free. Right now, only at Wine Stock's.
Congratulations to KCRA's Call 3 for two decades of service.
Once again, from our new CD, take a look. Here's Natalie Cole.
What's my day like? The sun comes up and my calls start coming. You want help calling overseas? I'm right here. Your kid needs to call you collect from camp. You need someone who speaks your language? I can help. Now, if you want to trade casserole recipes, my husband is the cook. By sundown, I've helped some people out. And if I'm lucky, there's a casserole waiting on the table.
The iPlan with a smile. AT&T operators.
Well, Citibank Visa provides so many services, you really don't need another card.
They were very pleasant. Citibank didn't put me on hold forever, which a lot of companies do these days.
The card's lost. Within 24 hours, I had a new card expressed to me that next day.
The fraud protection program really gave me a sense that somebody's looking out for me and my best interests.
And for some reason, on the phone, they're always very friendly with me. So maybe it's just my personality. I don't know.
Just a few of the many people who rely on the service of not just Visa, Citibank Visa.
The new Lexus GS is equipped with a vehicle speed-sensitive steering system so responsive that it actually improves your feel for the road. Now, the only thing more exhilarating than watching the Lexus GS is driving it. The new GS.
Okay, now, I am an optimist who has become very skeptical about fat-free salad dressings. So, naturally, when Healthy Sensation promised great honey Dijon taste, I thought, yeah, right. Just like you're thinking now. But Healthy Sensation has this sweet honey tangy Dijon thing. It's very creamy. It's very good. So try it. All you've got to lose is your cynicism.
Healthy Sensation. Taste and believe.
Tonight on Late Night, it's Those Stupid Human Tricks, plus Tom Selleck and Blues Traveler. Then tune out the noise and tune in to Friday Night Videos tonight.
It's a night to honor American heroes. Join President and Mrs. Clinton, Bill Cosby, Tom Selleck, and Anita Baker as they honor the great ones. A once-in-a-lifetime event. The greatest athletes of our century together for one night only. The National Sports Awards, Tuesday on NBC.
My next guest is only 12 years old, but he's already co-starring with Arnold Schwarzenegger in The Last Action Hero, which just opened today. He's gotten some terrific reviews. Please welcome Austin O'Brien. You just had a birthday, too, right?
I did. Actually, it was on the last day of filming, actually.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Actually, what happened is that at midnight, I had my birthday, because my birthday was that next day, but it was a lot of fun.
So now you're 12?
I'm 12.
That'd be what grade? Six, seven?
I'm going into seventh.
Seventh. So this has got to be, like, the coolest guy in school now, in the seventh grade.
I guess so.
Yeah. Yeah, well, that's got to be great to sit in math class and, hi, there's a guy in the movie. You good in school?
Yeah, I love school. I mean, I think it's a lot of fun to study and learn about all the things that have happened in the past. And math's my favorite subject, and science
math?
And literature.
Oh, man. This is like my mom's dream kid. Oh, man.
Easy.
Huh?
Easy.
Math. See, math was never mine. See, I always like history and stuff because you could, like, ask those questions. Well, teacher, what happened to Attila the Hun? And then they would go on and on. But math, you can't lie. You can't lie around math. You like sports? Do you play?
Oh, yeah, I love sports. I mean, baseball's my favorite sport, but,
yeah.
Yeah. I love baseball, and I also play other sports. I play basketball and soccer and football, but I also like to ride my bike and skateboard and rollerblade and have a good time.
Yeah, have a good time. It's pretty good. Girlfriends?
I have a lot of girls that are friends, but no girlfriend.
Oh, man, this is so we get into politics now. So no regular, just a lot of girls that are friends.
Yeah.
But nobody special.
Not yet.
Okay. So now, what have you done besides this film? Because this is the first thing I've seen. And you do a terrific job, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
A really nice job. Yeah, I really get into watching you. This is, how do you get picked for this? I mean, just go on an open audition? Do you meet Arnold the first day, or?
not quite, almost though. Well, I got sent on the first audition, and then I got a call back, so I guess I did a good job. Yeah. And then I got another call back, and at that call back, Arnold was there, and he was wearing shorts, and my brother was there, and he got to meet my brother, and after my brother had met Arnold, he went over to my mom, and he's like, "Mom! Check out the size of his legs! They're like the size of tree trunks!" It was really funny. Yeah. But, and then I read some more, I read some pages from the script with Arnold, and he was great, and then we went to the screen tests, and a couple of weeks later, the Lord blessed me, and here
you
I am.
You just get a phone call.
I got a phone call, yeah. Actually, my mom got beeped, and then...
Now, tell me, I thought it was interesting. Now, there were some words in the script you didn't want to say. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. I mean, if we found out that, actually, there were a few words that I wouldn't say, and I,
like four-letter words, cuss words, stuff like that?
Yeah, some of those, and then, like, sometimes they'd ask us to use the Lord's name in vain, and if I did that, we'd walk, so. But we didn't have to do that.
I think that's pretty good. I mean, that's pretty good to do that.
But then also they'd want me to say things like holy S and stuff like that.
Right.
And so I just say holy cow or darn it or stuff like that.
Well, you know, when I was doing comedy, I used to get in the club and people all say, "Oh, why do you work clean? You don't have to work clean." But why not? I mean, I think you go just as fine. I think it takes a lot of guts at age 12 to sort of, you know, on a big movie to make that decision.
Yeah.
Now, what is this clip we're going to see here?
This is a clip, and in it, you see Danny with his magic ticket, and this magic ticket enables him to get blown into the screen and ends up in the back seat of Jack Slater's car, and there's just a
lot. So he's a kid watching the movie who winds up in the movie.
That's right. His favorite action hero and his best friend, or his only friend, gives him his ticket, and he got it from Houdini, and then.
Let's take a look. Okay, this is scene. Last action hero. You got a terrific career ahead of you. You do a terrific job in this, and I like I like that decision. I think that's great. You should be very proud of yourself.
Thanks.
Austin O'Brien.
Yeah.
Good morning.
A warning from Ross. We've priced silk shirts so low they may not last. At department stores, they're $30. At Ross, they're half the price.
What makes summer fun?
Swimming. Ice cream. Picnic.
Fishing. Barbecues.
The summer sale and values
going on now
at Winestocks.
The new Lexus GS luxury performance sedan. It not only corners better than the BMW 540i, but it rides smoother. Of course, if you still insist on feeling every pebble in the road, be our guest. See the GS at your Lexus dealer. The price is within reach, too.
Hey, guys.
Hey, you guys.
How you doing, Larry?
Hi.
Barista Giulio Gallo invites you to take a new look at Chardonnay.
I like this one.
A very special Chardonnay for days like this.
It's really good.
This is great.
It's time for a change to Gallo.
At Home Base, our everyday prices are so low that if you ever see something advertised for less, just bring in the ad and we'll beat it by 5%.
To make Father's Day complete, give Dad the Genie 1/2 horsepower garage door opener. It comes with 2 3-function remote controllers and a deluxe wall console. Installation's available through June 23rd for only $59. So what are you waiting for? Let Genie open your dad's garage door. Home Base, it's that simple.
Weinstock's annual swimsuit sale. Save 20 to 50% on all 1993 Mrs. styles. The annual swimsuit sale on now at Weinstock's.
Accommodations furnished by Universal City Hilton and Towers. Ideally located within steps of the studios. Hilton, so nice to come home to.
All righty. I want to thank my guest, Austin O'Brien. The movie is The Last Action Hero. It opens tonight. Terrific. Thank you. Good to see you. Drew Carey, good luck with your special for Showtime.
Thanks very much.
And Natalie Cole, the CD is called Take a Look. And Bradford Marsalis hosting Friday Night Videos right after this. Hey, Monday night, Gloria Estefan, Nafi Modine, and composer Mark Scheinman. See you later. Bye-bye.